and this is how Ark of Men changed my life. My name is Matthew Boateng, and this is how Ark of Men changed my life.
Truth be told, I lost direction when my father passed away. He passed away when I was at the age of 13. And it's not until now that I'm in Christ and reflecting on the past that I realize how much young men and men in general need brotherhood and father figures in their life. At the time, life just became really tough. I began having a lot of anxiety attacks, and I just became really fearful. It came out of nowhere. That led me to smoking, drinking, and just doing a lot of things that was not conducive to the will of God over my life. Entering high school, I started playing football again, which helped me steer my mind in the right direction sometimes, but I always found myself falling back into the same exact trap. But my situation definitely got worse when I got to college. I thought I could do anything. I fell in love with money. I started fornicating. And I became highly disrespectful, especially to my elders. I literally spiraled out of control in every aspect of my life. I became the ringleader, and it got to a point where I felt no remorse at all for my sins. And that's when I knew I entered into iniquity. I started doing everything. You name it, I probably did it. All in light of trying to find happiness somewhere, but I never ever found it. It just became a cycle. I thought I could find happiness going to parties. I thought I could find happiness talking to girls wherever I went, not knowing that I was doing myself a disservice, doing harm to my destiny, my future. Completely ignorant to the devices of the enemy. But it was one experience that was truly the difference maker in this whole journey. God appeared to me himself and told me that based on the decisions that I make as a man and based on the decisions that I make from henceforth, it'll either keep my mother alive, or I'll be the reason why she dies. This happened shortly after my first Ark of Men's conference. During that conference, I experienced things that I'd never seen before. To see over 50 to 100 men gather in the body of Christ and pray until prayer prays. It's unheard of. When I say the atmosphere was on fire, I mean actual flames. It gave me a different perspective on what brotherhood looked like, on what brotherhood is supposed to look like. And at that moment, I just knew this is where I belong. We fellowshipped, we ate, we learned about fatherhood, we learned about how to love and how to be vulnerable as men. We even learned about finances, about how to get out of debt and stay out of debt, and attend to your family, take care of your family. Every aspect of being a successful kingdom man was taught during the Ark of Men conference. An experience that I'll never forget. An experience that truly changed me and planted the seed of Christ within me. The teachings overall just helped me differentiate who I thought I was and who I truly was in my identity in Christ. But of course, I fell back into the trap one more time. Through my disobedience, though, I was jumped by about 8 guys. And right then and there, I just knew that this was the exact experience that God was referring to during my encounter. Then the voice appeared again and told me that this is it. It's either you surrender and obey now, or you will face the consequences. Then Apostle and Prophetess popped up and moved me out to Connecticut. And that's how I was invited to my second Ark of Men conference, where the Spirit of God arrested me. I didn't realize the importance of fatherhood until I got around Apostle. Everything that I felt that I lost, God had restored to me through him. He took the place of my father. He taught me how to be a man. He taught me how to be confident, not prideful, but confident. He taught me that until I was sure of my identity in Christ, I can't manifest my true authority in life. He taught me how it feels to be loved again and how to love. He taught me that even as a man, I can be vulnerable. I can express my feelings. I can cry, and just by watching how good of a father he is to my nieces and nephews, and how good of a husband he is to Prophetess, my sister, it ignited a fire in me to not just live, just to live, but to live a life for God. And as a leader of this commission, it's honestly a privilege to learn from him. As a teacher, as a father, and most importantly, as an apostle and a servant of the Most High God.
May the Lord use you. From today, may your mind, your soul, be on the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I cut off every friend.
Jesus.
Any unfriendly friend.
Jesus.
Any girlfriend.
Jesus.
Any ex-friend.
Jesus.
I disconnect you. And I cut the umbilical cord.
Jesus.
Things that fought your father.
Jesus.
I disconnect those things from you.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, disconnect him.
Yes, Lord.
You said he'll be the first
Jesus.
To follow his sister.
Jesus.
Let him be the first.
Yes, Lord.
Let him be a testimony.
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 Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
No man is an island. You need me and I need you. And even if you don't have a father at home and you've been feeling abandoned for these last few years, I could truly assure you that you will find a father in Christ and a father through his manservant, Apostle Dominic. So I encourage you, come, just give God a chance, the same way I did. This Ark of Men, March 10th to March 13th. Come fellowship. Come be blessed. And just come have a good time. Most importantly, come experience God for yourself. I hope to see you all there.
Thank you.